Hello everyone, and welcome back to my Let's Play of Take on Mars. And this should be an exciting episode for our little space agency, in that we now have rovers. And so let's not waste any time, let's get started. And let's see what kind of rover missions we might do. Unfortunately, the time I've picked to record, Mars is in... mostly in darkness except for Gale Crater, so I guess we're going to go for Gale Crater. Okay, we see some new missions because I pretty much completed the missions from before. We've got this one. Wow, these are worth quite a lot, aren't they? 2,400, 1,400, though that one adds up to almost 2,400. And like that. And the rover cost 1,000. Okay, I've already taken a look at the rover just to make sure I had the instruments for the missions, because I might have failed to unlock one of the technologies, in which case I would have to go and do that before trying to record this video. So I do have the technologies necessary for these rovers. And one thing I have noticed, though, is that my budget is a little bit tight, isn't it? We really only have enough cash for one rover. It is a good thing, then, that before trying to record this episode, that I looked up some of the basics. But when I say basics, I mean basics. I'm not going to take any chances. Let's try... usually the one that is has less reward to it also happens to be easier, so I'm going to go with this. And let's see what our mission details are. Okay, explore. We used radiation thingamajiggy to analyze. We've got I forgot what the full name of that is. Anyway, we'll get to it. We have instruments other than the ones that we've been using, so that's a good mission to try out. Let's create a new rover. Let's see how to do that. Okay. Oh yes, alpha particle X-ray spectrometer. A little bit of a mouthful, but so what we need is a radiation assessment detector. Got it. Alpha particle X-ray spectrometer, and that goes in the. I really don't like taking up one of my cameras to have that, but okay. And then. It wants a black and white camera and a regular camera. Ooh. Well, let's go with the... oh, okay, that covers it. But this isn't even a black and white camera, it's a color camera. Why did it want a black and white camera if it wanted a color camera? Oh, forget it. Okay, so... now, what I have found out is that batteries are now important. They give your rovers power. None of the instruments seem to take any power, but moving around the surface sure does. So I'm gonna pack this thing full of batteries, because then we're going to be all good with power. Yeah, okay. So we've got plenty of capacity and power output, and we're not going to be at a loss for those. A little bit more costly, but as you will soon see, very effective. Okay, so we've got a pretty decent rover here. No point putting other instruments. Now you'll notice that the probe required a low gain antenna, but this doesn't, and we'll see why, I believe. So yeah, this is good, but I've got one chance to get this right, otherwise we're not going to have enough budget to launch another one. And that would be a disappointment. Now you'll notice I'm recording less than 1080p this time, and the reason for that is that I expect this mission to take a while, in which case I will run out of hard disk space at 1080p. At 1080p, an hour takes about 100 gigabytes, so just as a benchmark, and that's a lot. Okay. Here we go. Yeah, okay, that looks about as... can we get it even more accurate? I don't know. Yeah, there we go. Okay, let's launch. Okay, so here we are. We wanna. Oh? Is that a rover? Yeah, that's a rover. You can see. Whoop. Oh boy, that's the heat shield going. So there's our rover inside the container. But we'll zoom in and look at what the rover is doing. So here it is. I'm letting the computer do the landing because I don't want because budget constraints. I don't want to. Oh, okay. Let's zoom out and see what's happening. Oh, it's one of these sorts of things. Okay. I hope the computer knows what it's doing, because otherwise we're in trouble. I don't want it to end up on the. Whoa, there's some sharp rocks there. Oh, please don't. A, please don't have the rover be like upside down. B, please don't make it so that I have to like exit on the sharp rocks. No, it should be all right now. There's enough clearance. Well, maybe. Depends on whether the. How does this open? Oh. Aw, nuts. Oh no. It's got me on a rock. This is not good. This is not good at all. Okay, which way is forward? Oh, this is very weird to control. What am I gonna do? Come on, little rover. You can do it. You can do it. Okay. All right, careful now. Careful. Ooh. It seems like I have so much battery power that it's actually blinking over here. That's weird. Well, that's a good thing. We won't have to worry about it too much. Now, we've got all these markers, and now I have to pay attention to these markers. They said on the internet that I should be going for a yellow marker. But hold on, they also said that I should filter by near, major, and yes. Aha. Okay, so those markers were not for our mission. See, now with a rover, we can go to things that are not our. Uh-oh. But I don't see anything. Okay, how about all priorities, include some far ones. There? Let me filter by mission no now. Does that look yellow or green? Well, this one over here that's like 7.8. So I don't care. I'm going for there. I mean, this even if it's not our mission, it's so close that I might as well do it, whatever it happens to be. Ooh, this is weird. Okay, I'm using my control stick to control it, by the way, because I figured out that control stick is active, and if I try and use the keyboard, it controls a little bit weird. Okay, so what do I do? Looks like we have infinite uses on this one, so go for it. No target in range. Okay. What about the radiation one? Huh. That's worrisome. Tasks. Explore. While I'm exploring. Oh, let's explore. Yeah, let's go to the camera view. Maybe we've got some camera things to do. But they said that the camera markers were red, so. And did we? Yeah, we. I think. Oh, explore complete. Okay, good. But this isn't the explore that we're supposed to do. This is an extra explore. So this is the actual rover camera, and I can't turn it around, annoyingly enough. Yeah. All I can do is turn the rover. Whoa, that was quick. So here I am turning the rover. Oh, come on. No. So there doesn't seem to be any camera things in sight, but let's go for the standard HUD. Okay, so if I narrow to major filter by mission, yes. Okay, that's still there. Okay, so that must be our mission thing, I hope. Okay, full speed ahead. Full speed apparently is 24 watt hours. Oh, our chemical battery drain seems to be draining. Oh boy. I don't know if we're gonna make this. This is probably a lot more than a rover is normally expected to go in a day. But maybe it's because I didn't land it properly. Maybe if I landed it closer to the target, it would have been better. But I have no idea how to control that big rolly thing. And we didn't really get to control the shell portion of it the last time. So I don't know if controlling that's even a thing. This is some hard traveling, folks. I like this view. I have to figure out how to get the GUI off, though. Having the UI up is a little bit of a it detracts from the scenery, really. Even in this view, it sort of detracts from the scenery. Ooh, let's take a look at what's going on here. There seems to be a patch of something over there, huh? So maybe I didn't need so many batteries. I think I could have done with one of the chemical batteries and one of the basic batteries would have probably been enough in terms of charge rate. But then there's my battery level. I don't know if, I mean, it looks like I seem to be running out of it pretty quickly. So maybe for the sake of my battery level, I do need as many as possible. If we manage to get this mission done right, I probably want to look for some better batteries. Or solar panels. Solar panels would be good. Why didn't we already unlock solar panels? I have no idea. Well, of course, Mars doesn't have very good solar input, so maybe that's the thing. Okay, about a third of the way there now. Looks like we'll make it at least. I'd say this rover has at least a kilometer range on it. strange. I mean, we ended up landing so far away from our mission target when with the lander we were able to land like within a meter or a couple of meters. But of course, I guess with a rover, if you're going to have a rover, it's a little bit more fun to land far away. I don't know. Okay, well, we've got this ridge here. Let's be careful about going up this. Whoa. 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 Okay, good. Okay, another ridge. About halfway there now. Still trucking along. I hope the radiation experiment is working. Maybe that's why we had to land far away, because we've been taking radiation readings all this time. I hope it's a passive instrument like that. Let me give you an idea of what this looks like from the exterior. This is what we're... Oh, rock. So yeah, unlike the landers and the probes, these rover missions are bound to take a while. So that's why I decided to go for the lesser resolution so that I could get more done in each video. Otherwise, there was the possibility that I might have to end the video in the middle of a mission, and that wouldn't be any good. There's no guarantee that this is the only spot we have to get to. Though so far it seems like it's the only marker. It seemed like we needed to take two readings. Oh, that seems like a very steep thing. Let me go around this way. Yeah, so I don't know where the second reading would have to happen. Maybe this is just the first thing we have to do. Oh. Some of the rough ground sound seems to have stopped. That's interesting. And more music. Let me give it a rest for a sec as we have the final leg of our journey. And show you what happens when we have this satellite view. And this satellite view doesn't really show much, honestly. There we are. And unfortunately, it doesn't seem to show any of the markers. That's what I would like most. I really wish this satellite view would show me some markers, any markers. But no, it doesn't do that. And once it's centered on that, you can't pan the thing around. So let's uncenter that. Now we can pan the view, but still there's nothing to see except for the terrain, and let's face it, we can see the part of the terrain that we want to see from out here better than in that view. So oh, explore complete, good. There are some little shiny rocks. I feel like I should be taking soil samples, but of course we don't have an instrument for that. Let me get the mouse out of the way. Oh, okay, well this is a bit steep. Ooh. Huh, plucky little rover. Hasn't had too much trouble so far. You wouldn't want to get stuck on a boulder, but still, you know. Okay. So yeah, altogether I'd say I've got a little bit more than a kilometer's worth of range here, given our chemical battery level. Okay, so what do I do now? Well, let's see if this works now. No target in range. Well, fudge. Alpha particle, X-ray spectrum. Maybe those glowing rocks? Can we get those glowing rocks? Or maybe I'm in the wrong view. Let's say I'm in this view. No. That's really all I've got, huh? And we've got zero of our mission complete. We're at the bloody marker. There is no other marker. There's no other marker in sight. Let's go back to the standard HUD here. Okay, that's a marker. There's no other marker. None. Let's go to negligible priority. There's still no other mission marker in sight. Let's go general. Okay, there's one there. But I think we already got, well that's a photo one, I think. We can go there. We better, I guess. No limit. Now we've got all these markers. Oh, maybe filter by mission, yes. And no limit. Nope. Even if you go completely limitless, there's no other marker involved. Okay. So much for looking on the web to try and figure out how to do this. This is frustrating. Right. I'm feeling a little bit dismayed, and I think there's a high probability I'm not going to fulfill this mission, in which case I'm gonna be stuck in a dead end here. Why can't, come on you little AP alpha particle X-ray spectrometer, do something. They need some serious documentation with this. I saw a little glowing stuff. Okay, well, at least I'm getting these little points for exploring stuff. Oh, wait. Oh, it's in this corner here. Whoa. Well, where did they pop up suddenly? They didn't show up before, did they? Okay, this way. I feel like I'm going crazy over here. They were so not there. Oh, wait a minute. Were they not there because I had... No? Were they not there because... Oh, well, that one goes away if I click major. That's a minor thing. Okay. And we have to be in instrument HUD in order to see it. Alright. Let's do this. Okay, I feel a little bit better now. I hope the radiation reading thing is automatic, because I don't have a way to turn that on. And yeah, I didn't point it out, but the antenna is built into the little pyramid-shaped thing that we entered on. So this one has its own little antenna that connects to that, and that connects back to base, I think. I think that's what's going on here. Just interpreting. Wow, our battery level is going down pretty quickly now. We didn't travel that far. Okay, is this close enough? No target in range. Oh, no, come on, this way. Oh, it's got a little cone thing. Well, that's picky, isn't it? Okay, figure out how to drive, come on. I wonder if people get Rover driver licenses. No target in range. Wow, they're picky, aren't they? Okay. Oh, I guess my instrument is on the other side, I think. Oh, this is weird and tough. Tougher than anything we've done so far, that's for sure. Okay, let me see how it's going on here. So which end? Okay, show me what you're seeing, camera. Camera? Oh, right, I have to go into this view. You're seeing this. Right. Huh. Wait a sec. Oh, I didn't even notice that before. That's our heat shield. Well, that's interesting. At least something got to the right site before. Whatever. Anyway, okay. Okay, let's stick our nose in here. Can we analyze now? Look. I just noticed this distance thing here. That's distance to the... I can't do it. Why? My little... That's the alpha X-ray spectrometer, I think. And it's sticking into the zone. Oh, well... Poo. Okay, let's try for one of the radiation ones. At least those are bigger and not totally obscured by a rock. Okay, well, yes, obviously that's not going to happen. Oh, wait, we've got something complete. That's nice. Okay, that disappeared. Okay, great. Okay. Oh, let's clear up some of this stuff. This is all old stuff. July 25th. At least they give a date on this. August 1st. August 1st, August 1st, August 1st. Okay, now we're getting... Okay, so these are the stuff we researched on entering. Hey, where's my notification that I've succeeded in the task? Oh, Wait a minute, I was just sitting here and it went from 50 to 62%. Okay. Well, we're going this way. This way. Let's go for the radiation stuff before I try and figure out what's going on with the alpha particles stuff. Okay. It looks like I have to get the entire vehicle into the area, which is well, very difficult in the case of that one stone. Yes, no. Okay, good. Takes it a while sometimes. Maybe I just need to stick around inside one of the areas in order to make sure. It looks like the radiation ones are the more important mission. So I might get the 1,400 if I just do those. So let's focus on that. Yes. Yes. Okay, 100% complete on the major tasks. Hopefully now they've given me, yes, notification, major tasks complete. Okay, let's try this stone one. Come on, it's only 31 centimeters. It's 15 centimeters, 18 centimeters even. Come on. Five centimeters. Oh wait, it's moving, it's doing it. Oh wow. Finally. Wow, you have to get like 5 centimeters away. Okay. Well, at least we know it works. All right. We're less than two-thirds of our battery level though. I want to try and do some other missions too. I want to see what those other markers were all about. So I don't want to just be stuck around here. Yay! Temporary results, content coming soon. Good, good. They should work on that. And tutorials. It's a good thing that I figured out from looking on the web what the markers were for before starting this, otherwise I'd been totally lost. And it wasn't so easy to find either. It was just like one article on some forum post on this. I think it was from the Steam discussions. Okay, so what was the other one? Okay, there it is. Twenty percent only, huh? We've got some other minor tasks that we're supposed to be doing. I guess it must be camera stuff. Let's just take a look quickly and see if it is. Oh yeah, we've got some camera stuff, but problem is we have to turn the rover around. We can't turn the camera. Sort of silly, we had the ability to turn the camera. Come on. We had the ability to turn the camera with Lander. Okay, well, let's. Okay, good. Wow, those are far away. Okay, good. Those are really far. Okay, well, those are far away, so let's focus back on our instrument HUD, and that's stone, right? I wonder what the sometimes. Oh, there's two stones. Okay, well, we'll have to get both of those if possible. Sometimes I wonder what the distance is measuring to. What are we 2 meters away from? I don't see that we're 2 meters away from anything. Okay, this one looks closer, doesn't it? Now, I haven't tried it, but there is the sort of green and red that you would expect from 3D. What kind of 3D is that? I forget the name of it. But anyway, the one where you wear the glasses and, red green is separated. So this could be giving us a 3D view of this, similar to what you get in Minecraft 3D, if you've ever tried that. But I haven't tried it yet, so I'm not sure if that works. But it would seem like that might be a thing. Or maybe they were just imitating the camera from the rover and it doesn't actually work. I don't know. Okay, let me back out and see what how to get our distance to 5 centimeters or something like that. Let's see if it's this way. Yeah. Okay, is 10 close enough? No. Well, I'm not getting any closer than 10, it looks like. Still not satisfied. Practically climbing up the thing. It's the worst instrument ever. You know what the problem is? The problem is I didn't mount it on this side. See, let's back it off for a sec. See, these wheels stick out a bit more. At least it looks like it. No, well, yeah. So this side would be able to get at that a little bit easier than this side because of the wheels. But still, it's really, really annoying. Okay, how about no? Okay, yes. Oh, okay. Wow. I hope I didn't break the rover's wheels or anything. This is pretty darn serious. Aw, nuts, come on. Okay, little rover, hold steady there. I wish we had parking brakes. Half of our charge left. Well, as you can see, these rover missions are a lot longer than the lander missions. And I expected that, of course, but they even so, this is way beyond what I thought it would be. Because we still haven't even completed our tasks yet. The next one, stone, is over there. Okay. You might notice that I have a little bit of difficulty steering sometimes, and that's because sometimes the controls are not what I think they are. For instance, right now I'm pushing forward on my control stick, but left turns me right, and right turns me left. And then sometimes I guess I'm going backwards with the rover, in which case I actually have everything reversed even then. So it's all very weird. Takes a little bit of testing first whenever I try and start out again to see which way I should be going. I still have no idea what this stuff does. And since I don't know what it does, and it doesn't seem to be contributing anything right now, I really wish we didn't have it so that I'd at least get a nicer view for myself. Another thing, the toggle cameras could be a little bit smaller. But then again, I'm not doing it in 1080p anymore, so maybe that's what I'm irritated by. The lesser size. It's in 1600 by 900 right now. One other reason I decided to go with that is because in the 1080p videos, the text was not coming out crisp. And so I think that if I go with this resolution, you'll be able to see the text a little bit better. It's a compression problem, and I still haven't fixed it yet. I haven't figured out what it is. It's not the bitrate. That's the only thing I know. Oh, my rover is having a little bit of trouble getting this up this hill. Come on, little rover. So, for next time, I'm going to have to remember to attach the alpha particle X-ray spectrometer to the opposite side of the rover so that I can get closer to the targets. No, this is easier, I think. Well, maybe not. Ah, there we go. Stop there. Okay, good. Alright. I guess these little alpha particles can't travel very far. Alpha particles are just helium atoms, aren't they? But anyway. Okay. Didn't really add to our completion rate, apparently. Huh. Okay, I think we still need to take some photos. Where would we do that? Okay, over there. I feel like I keep crossing that area and never quite... Okay, but... Okay, that's back. Good. On the bright side, I think we've definitely gotten enough cash to proceed with future missions. Okay, let's go to this view and see if we can't get some of these things. Here we go. That should work. Come on. Okay, good. Okay, so... Alright, there's one. Problem is that we need the camera to figure out how to point up. Wait a minute. It was green back there. Hold on. Well, it's green now, even if we're at a weird angle. So, okay. Okay, well, there's another spot. Can you take it now? Okay. Whatever they want at home, they're gonna get it. Wow, it doesn't look like I could have gotten away with less battery at all. Uh-oh, I think I'm doing something stupid. Am I? No. Oh, that's probably a bad idea, actually. I don't know what this rover can and cannot get stuck on, but I don't want to try and find out now. Oh, we've traveled a kilometer. Achievement unlocked. That's great. Okay, well, there's another one there. Okay. Right, so where's the next one? Stop right there. That was just green a minute ago. Okay, there we go. Oh, I guess they want this rock. Fair enough. Come on, cursor. All right, so that's the end of our assigned missions. And while we're here, filter mission no limit. Yeah, okay, good. That's exactly what I want. Let's see now. Oh, well, let's go for near distance markers of any priority. None. Okay, maybe we should be a little bit more adventurous. We're not filtering by mission here. Where did all the little markers go? Ah, I thought there were more things to do. Okay, no limit. Okay, there's some markers over there. How far away are those? Well, maybe I'll just leave it here for now. It's still workable. It's called Explorer, so we're gonna have to remember that. And yeah, I think this is a good place to conclude this. So for now, let me disconnect and let's go back and see how much cash we racked up from this whole thing. We've been here for a while. All right, so let's go and take a look at that. Okay, so about 1,600, 1,700-ish. I'm not gonna try and open any more technologies in the tech tree just yet. Some of them are pretty expensive. Look at that. 6,350 for improved mobile chassis. This is a solar array for a lander, not for a rover. Small rover solar array. Yeah, I think I'll research this one since I mentioned it. Okay, so but that's the only thing I'm going to research, and because we want to make sure we can do as many rover missions as possible, and we've got enough, I think, for about three more, so that's good. So just in case I totally fail, I've got that going for me. My next question is, can we do that? No. Even with our nifty little rover, we cannot do the North Polar Cap. Okay, fine. Fine. Alright, but the air locations are in the dark, so I'm gonna try and find a time where I can go to one of the others and see if they look a little bit different, if they're a little bit different to drive around in. Clearly, there's a lot of spots here in Victoria Crater. Look at all those. These are probe spots, but these other ones are... Wow, that's expensive. Wow, that's... We could, triple our budget with this one. Okay. This one's a little bit easier. I bet this one is gonna take hours to complete or something. Anyway, so you get the idea. And we'll try something a little bit more challenging. I don't think I'm up to trying to land the rover just yet, but maybe if we do one of these, I'll risk it. So that'll be a thing. So yeah, so tune in next time to see more rover mayhem as we try and get rovers all around the surface of Mars. I think Gale Crater was a pretty tame environment, but there are more challenging environments than that, and so we'll see how we do there. Alright, so thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please do press like. If you have any comments or suggestions, please leave them in the comment section below, and I'll see you next time.